Okay, I'm going to read 2 Peter 2. But there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you who privily... Now, don't be thinking that everybody you watch on TV or wherever is a false prophet, okay? Let's just stay in the Word and stay close to God and His Word, okay? And don't start labeling everybody as a false prophet. And He will show you, okay? And just be careful, okay? But there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privily shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them. I mean, you know, you want to get technical about these things, you know. Okay, I won't go there. Even denying the Lord that bought them and bringing upon themselves swift destruction. And many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. And through covetousness shall they with feigned words make merchandise of you, whose judgment now of a long time lingereth not, and their damnation slumbereth not. For if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down in hell, and delivered them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment, and spared not the old world, but saved Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly. You know, don't be afraid to read these hard words, okay? These heavy words, okay? It helps us to stay close to God, okay? But you don't have to make a movement out of these things, okay? Just stay in the Word and read all of the Word of God, okay? And I know you can't do that every single day. I know that you can't read the whole Bible, but just keep going, okay? Just let the Lord lead you where He wants you to read on any particular day or at any particular time, okay? Because He's the God of the whole world, Word and the whole world, okay? And it all works together for your good. And spared not the old world, but saved Noah, the eighth person, a preacher. This is verse 5 out of 2 Peter. Bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly. See, he says here, making them an example unto that after should live ungodly, and delivered just Lot, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked. For that righteous man dwelling among them in seeing and hearing vexed his righteous soul from day to day with their unlawful deeds. The Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptations, and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. And to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished, but chiefly them that walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanness, and despise government. Presumptuous are they, self-willed, they are not afraid to speak evil of dignities, whereas angels, which are greater in power and might, bring not railing accusations against them before the Lord. But these, as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption, and shall receive the reward of unrighteousness, as they that count it pleasure in riot in the daytime. Spots are they and blemishes, sporting themselves with their own deceivings while they feast with you, having eyes full of adultery, and that cannot cease from sin, beguiling unstable souls, and heart have they exercised with covetous practices, cursed children, which have forsaken the righteous way and are gone astray, following the way of Balaam, the son of Bosar, who loved the wages of unrighteousness, but was rebuked for his iniquity. The dumb ass, speaking with man's voice, forbade the madness of the prophet. These are wells without water, clouds that are carried into a tempest, to whom the midst of darkness is reserved forever. For when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allure through the lusts of the flesh, through much wantonness, those that were clean escaped from them who live in error. While they promise them liberty, they themselves are the servants of corruption. For of whom a man is overcome, of the same is he brought in bondage. For, see, just read the word, okay? And don't try to decipher every single thing out of the word unless the Lord leads you into a study of it. That's fine. But just this helps us, okay? For if after they, and don't read it like you're reading like you're for everybody else. No, this is first for you when you read the word. It's first for you, okay? Even if you're a pastor or a preacher or an evangelist of all people, yes, keep reading, because the enemy is full of tricks, okay? For if after, you know, pride comes before a fall. You know, we get so heady and high-minded, look at me, like I'm up here, and look at how much God has this and God has that. You know, no, stay humble, man, because that's when the devil can really deceive somebody and tempt them. And then, okay, pride cometh before a fall, but God gives grace to the humble. So continue to know that we're all sinners saved by grace. For if after they have escaped the pollutions of the world through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein and overcome, the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. For it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness than after they have known it to turn from the holy commandment delivered unto them. But it has happened unto them, according to the true proverb, the dog is turned to his own vomit again, and the sow that was washed to her wallowing in the mire. Now, go ahead and keep reading, but I just wanted to interject this just heavy chapter. It's really good, and Old Testament stuff, too. Stay in the Word. Stay in the Gospels. You know, read about Jesus. Brings him down here, the Gospels, the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And do some epistles, and Psalms, and Proverbs, Old Testament, Genesis, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Daniel, you know, all of the Old Testament, and read it in the light of the New Testament if you're a Christian. Okay. God bless.